Blackstone presents Dawn by Sevgi Soysal, translated by Maureen Freely. This book is read by Vaneh, Assadourian. Preface. When Mustafa Kemal Atatürk founded the Republic of Turkey in 1923, he put women at the epicenter of his modernizing vision. At home and in the workplace, they would be the ones to bring the nation up to Western standards. In 1926, he replaced Sharia law with the Swiss Civil Code, thereby bringing an end to polygamy and a husband's right to unilaterally repudiate a wife at his discretion. He gave women the right to vote and run for office in 1934, well in advance of many countries in Europe, including France. But the very next year, he closed the Turkish Women's Union, which had been instrumental in effecting this change. His authoritarian single-party regime saw no need for women to organize on behalf of women, now that they had full and equal status with men. This was the paradox into which Sevgi Soysal was born. A nation that had granted women equality on condition they did not question its terms. And that's how it remained for the first 30 years of her life. All around her, women were rising in the ranks. Their many contributions to the national cause were much heralded. What they themselves thought about their lives, the world, and what it required of its women was politically irrelevant. But for those with the inclination, there was always the disobedient pen. There was rarely a moment in her short life when Sevgi did not have that pen to hand. Even as a student, she was writing in arts journals, not so much to expound on what she knew, but to explore what she did not. She grew up in Ankara, Turkey's new and fiercely patriotic capital. Her mother was German. Her architect father was a refugee from Greece. She had many doors open to her, and she walked through them all. In sharp contrast to what might have been expected in 1950s Europe and America, an early marriage proved no impediment. She already had a young son when she took up jobs with Radio Ankara and the German Cultural Center. In the same years, she began a distinguished side career as a translator, published her first book of short stories, and performed at the National Theater in two plays she herself had translated. Her husband was away doing his military service when she took to the stage. She fell in love with a fellow performer who became her second husband. Suddenly, the main breadwinner, she took up a senior post at Turkish radio and television, where she proved herself a pioneer in progressive women's programming. Even during the fallow years before second-wave feminism came to Turkey, as it did everywhere, she was bringing women's voices into questioning conversations about sex, marriage, children, and families. Her first novel, Walking, explored the same terrain with eloquence and daring. It won a national prize, only to be banned for obscenity. Undeterred, Sevgi went on to write Tante Rosa, about the women on the German side of her family. Now a classic, it was derided at the time for sounding like a translation. And here we come to the troubles for which she is unfortunately best known. While her second husband was away doing his military service, she met and fell in love with distinguished professor of constitutional law, Mumtaz Soysal. Their happy days were soon cut short by the infamous memorandum of March 12, 1971, by which the military seized control of the country. For most of the next 2 years, much of Turkey was under martial law, as the generals now in charge did their utmost to crush the left. Sevgi was among the first to be removed from her job. Mumtaz was sent to Mamak prison, charged with spreading communist propaganda, and it was here that the two married. Soon, Sevgi was in prison herself, charged not just with spreading communist propaganda, but also with obscenity. All three of the books for which she is best known have their roots in the 8 months she spent behind bars. The first is Noontime in Yenisheir, the novel that she wrote in prison at the rate of 8 pages a day between breakfast and gymnastics. The second is Yıldırım District Women's Barracks, her memoir of life inside. The third is The Book in Your Hand. I first read Dawn 45 years ago. I translated it during lockdown as democracy foundered everywhere, and it broke my heart once again. For though it is set in the early 1970s, it could just as easily have happened yesterday. Like Orhan Pamuk's Snow, it is the Turkish tragedy writ small. In contrast to Snow...
We hope you enjoyed this preview. To continue listening to this audiobook on Google Play Books, use the link in the video description.